was a kid, I'd take a trip every summer down to Mississippi to visit my granny and her antebellum world. I'd run barefooted all day long, climbing trees free as a song. And one day I happened to catch myself a squirrel. Well, I stuffed him down in an old shoebox and punched a couple holes in the top. When Sunday came, I snuck him into church. I was sitting way back in the very last pew, showing him to my good buddy Hugh, when that squirrel got loose and went totally berserk. Well, what happened next is hard to tell. Some thought it was heaven, others thought it was hell. But the fact that something was among us was plain to see. As the choir sang, "I surrender all," the squirrel ran up Harv Newland's coveralls, and Harv leaped to his feet and said, "Something's got a hold on me." Yow! The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleeping little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!" Well, Harv hit the aisles dancing and screaming. Some thought he had religion, others thought he had a demon. And Harv thought he had a weed eater loose in his Fruit of the Looms. He fell to his knees to plead and beg, and the squirrel ran out of his britches leg unobserved to the other side of the room. All the way down to the Amen pew, where sat Sister Bertha Better Than You, who'd been watching all the commotion with sadistic glee. You should have seen the look in her eyes when that squirrel jumped her garters and crossed her thighs, and she jumped to her feet and said, "Lord, have mercy on me." As the squirrel made laps inside her dress, she began to cry and then to confess to sins that would make a sailor blush with shame. She told of gossip and church dissension, but the thing that got the most attention was when she talked about her love life. And then she started naming names. The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!" Well, 7 deacons and the pastor got saved, and $25,000 got raised, and 50 volunteered for missions in the Congo on the spot. And even without an invitation, there were at least 500 rededications, and we all got rebaptized, whether we needed it or not. Now you've heard the Bible story, I guess, how he parted the waters for Moses to pass, all the miracles God has wrought in this old world. But the one I'll remember till my dying day is how he put that church back on the narrow way with a half-crazed Mississippi squirrel. The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, "Hallelujah!" The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival.
Sneaky snake. Now maybe you won't see him, and maybe you won't hear, but he'll sneak up behind you and drink all of your root beer. And then sneaky snake goes dancing, wiggling and a hissing. Sneaky snake goes dancing, giggling and a kissing. Sneaky snake, he laughs too much, you see. When he goes wiggling through the grass, it tickles his underneath. Well, sneaky snake drinks root beer, and he just makes me sick. When he is not dancing, he looks just like a stick. Now he doesn't have any arms or legs, you cannot see his ears. And while we are not looking, he's stealing all of our beer. And then Sneaky Snake goes dancing, wiggling and a hissing. Sneaky Snake goes dancing, a giggling and a kissing. I don't like old Sneaky Snake, he laughs too much, you see. When he goes wiggling through the grass, it tickles his underneath. Drink a beer to keep his britches on his hips. I knew I had to ask him about the mysteries of life. He spit between his boots and he replied, it's faster horses, younger women, older whiskey, more money. He smiled and all his teeth were covered with tobacco stain. He said it don't do men no good to pray for peace and rain. Peace and rain is just a way to save prosperity, and buffalo chips is all it means to me. I told him I was a poet, I was looking for the truth. I do not care for horses, whiskey, women, or the loot. I said I was a writer, my soul was all on fire. He looked at me and he said, you are a liar. Son, it's faster horses, younger women, older whiskey, more money. Well, I was disillusioned, if I say the least. I grabbed him by the collar and I jerked him to his feet. There was something cold and shiny laying by my head, so I started to believe the things he said. Well, my poet days are over and I'm back to being me. As I enjoy the peace and comfort of reality, if my boy ever asks me what it is that I have learned, I think that I will readily affirm. Son, it's faster horses, younger women, older whiskey, more money.
Bob, he steal, gamble, and rob. He thought he was the smartest guy around. Well, I found out last Monday that Bob got locked up Sunday. They've got him in the jailhouse way downtown. He's in the jailhouse now. He's in the jailhouse now. Well, I told him once or twice to stop playing cards and a shooting dice. He's in the jailhouse now. Peanut, whist, and yoker, but shooting dice was his favorite game. Well, he got thrown in jail with nobody to go his bail. The judge done said that he refused the fine. He's in the jailhouse now. He's in the jailhouse now. Or twice, stop playing cards and a shooting dice. He's in the jailhouse now. Said I was the swellest guy around. Well, we started to spending my money, and she started to calling me honey. We took in every cabaret in town. We're in the jailhouse now. We're in the jailhouse now. Well, I told that judge right to his face